As individuals in a community, we all play an important role in making society function. Some of us make buses run to schedule. Some of us give entertaining 3-minute thesis presentations. And some of us build houses for others to live in. What would happen though if an entire group of people, say firefighters, just disappeared overnight? What would happen to our community? Probably chaos. Now let me tell you about another community. The gut microbiome is the collection of microorganisms that inhabit the gut. And like workers in our society, each species of bacteria has a particular function and a particular role to play in the greater bacterial community. If one of these species is missing, well, this might be the microbial equivalent of all-night riots and a couple of overturned flaming cars. Now that's not good for the bacterial community. And it's certainly not good for us, their hosts. My research involves looking at the gut microbiome of healthy people and comparing this to people with inflammatory bowel disease. When we compare these two groups, we can see which bacteria are in the healthy group but are missing from those with inflammatory bowel disease. And these bacteria might hold the key to treating inflammatory bowel disease. Unfortunately, many of these bacteria have never been grown in a lab before. So, that's where I come in. First, I need to find these species, separate them from other bacteria, and then grow them by figuring out what they need to live. I then want to see whether they'll be able to put out a couple of fires in a chaotic colonic community. And so I screen them for anti-inflammatory activity and see whether they are able to prevent or cure inflammatory bowel disease in mice. If this research is successful, I will develop the first live bacterial therapeutic to specifically treat inflammatory bowel disease. But I won't stop there. The gut microbiome is associated with a huge number of impairments, including anxiety and depression, rheumatoid arthritis, obesity, and diabetes. If this drug development process works, then I might be able to use it to treat these other impairments, and this could affect a conservatively estimated 66% of the Australian population. That means a 2 in 3 chance of affecting you. One day, you will test your gut microbiome as often as you now test your blood. My research and gut microbiome research around the world is creating this new reality, ushering in a new paradigm and a new age of medicine.